Hi friends, in the previous video for the generator matrix G equal to 100 010 001 011 101 101 110, we got the check bits as C1 equal to M2 XOR M3, C2 equal to M1 XOR M3, C3 equal to M1 XOR M2. Before going that, we will see the operation of XOR gate. For XOR, there will be two inputs. For two input XOR gate, this is A and B, this is output. For two input, there will be four possibilities: 00 01 10 11. The operation of XOR gate is, when the both values are different, the output will be high. When the both are same, the output will be zero. We will continue. Here we have three messages, and in the question they have not mentioned about what is the message. So here we have eight combinations. We will see the all combinations, the code vectors. This is message M1, M2, M3. This is C1, C2, C3. These are message bits. These are check bits. And this is code vector. And this is weight of the code. Here the messages are 3, so we have 8 combinations: 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and 111. Total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, total 8. The value of CN is M2 XOR M3. If XOR 00, we will get 0, 0 XOR 1, 1. When both are different, the value is high, that means 1. Here 1 0 0 1 1 0. C2 is nothing but M1 XOR M3, the XOR of these two: 00 0 0 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0. C3 is M1 XOR M2. 0 XOR 0 is 0, 0 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 is 0. Here the code vector is nothing but this is M and this is C. Message followed by C equal to message followed by this check bits. This is code. M and C. C is check bits. Why we are placing these message bits here means we are using only systematic code in linear block codes. So the code vector is, the code vector output consists of 6 bits. Message followed by code. These values are 000. Next one is 000. 001, 110. 010, 101. 011. 011 100 011 101 101 101 110 111 110 111 000. Weight of the code is nothing but the number of bits that are 1 in the code vector. Simply the non-zero values are nothing but the weight of the code. Here in this, number of 1s are 0. So the code weight is 0. Here number of 1s present in this code vector is 3. Here 3, here 4, here 3, here 4, here 4, and here 3. Here we have found the code vector. Now we will see the minimum distance. The minimum distance between the code vectors is nothing but the minimum value of the weight of the non-zero code is nothing but the minimum distance. Here the minimum value is 0, but we should not consider this because the minimum distance is nothing but the number of bits that are non-zeros. Here the minimum weight of the non-zero vector is 3. This is the minimum weight. D minimum equal to 3. Now we'll see the error detection and error correction capabilities. First we'll see the error rate, how to detect the error. Here we can determine only how many bits can has errors and how many bits that can be corrected, but we cannot say directly which bit can be corrected. For the error detection, the minimum distance d minimum is greater than or equal to s plus 1. S is nothing but the number of bits that can be detected. We have got the minimum distance is 3. 3 is greater than s plus 1. S plus 1 is less than or equal to 3. S less than or equal to 3 minus 1. S less than or equal to 2. The meaning of this is we can correct. Here we can detect at most 2 errors. Now we will see how many bits that can be corrected. For error correction, the minimum distance should be always greater than or equal to 2t plus 1, where t is nothing but number of bits that can be corrected. Here we have the minimum distance is 3 greater than or equal to 2t plus 1, 2t plus 1 less than or equal to 3, 2t less than or equal to 2, t less than or equal to 1. That means here we can correct at most, that means maximum 1 bit. Only one error can be corrected. Okay friends, now we'll see a small property. Show that G into H transpose equal to H into G transpose equal to 0 for systematic linear block code. Here we have seen that G is the generator matrix, but we have not seen what is H here. We will see now about this. Here H is nothing but the parity check matrix. The parity check matrix H equal to, this will be P transpose and I. So there will be Q by Q values, and here output is Q by N. Here P transpose is nothing but the transpose of the submatrix, and here I is the identity matrix. The parity submatrix P has order of size is K by Q. The P transpose has size of Q by K because this is the transpose of P. Now we'll see this. G into H transpose equal to H into G transpose equal to 0. The G is the generator matrix with a size of K by N. So G equal to I followed by P submatrix. This size is K by K and this is K by Q. and h equal to, and h as the size of q by n, and p transpose as size of q by k, and I of size q by k, and total h size is q by n. Now h into g transpose equal to h is p transpose q by k into I into q by q into g transpose is nothing but these two, this will be here and this will come downside, I by k here, this p will be turned to p transpose. We'll see how this way. Let us take an example. G equal to I value is 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, and the parity p is 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0. G transpose is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, and here this will be 1 0 0 1 0 1 1, next one is 0 1 0 1 0 1, and this is 0 0 1 1 1 0. If we divide this, we will, G transpose is written as, this is I and this is P. Here this is I and this is the transpose of this P. So we will get this as P transpose. So here we have written this as I by P transpose. On simplifying this, we will get, this will be multiplied by this, we will get P transpose. On addition with this, on this multiplying with this, we will get finally as P transpose. We have previously seen that for exergates, when different values are XORed with same value, we will get as 0. All values will be 0. So H into G transpose equal to 0. Similarly, the G into H transpose is also 0.